I know more than I should talk about, in terms of some of the people who write things and do things to disparage other people. But I can say that a lot of times, because I'm not the only one that people, have made fun of, as you know. I mean, there's a young friend of mine named Jason Momoa, who was supposed to be here, who canceled. Yeah, I don't know Jason so well that I would swear to it, but my feeling about Jason is a very humble, very spiritual, very good man. I read an article the other day. I won't even tell you the kinds of terrible, outrageous, defaming, disgusting things they were writing about him. And the long and the short is, I think there's always people who think, I can be bigger than them. I can be better. I can get more attention. I can get more money if I screw them over by lying and disparaging them. And there's that, and there's the jealous, and there's the haters, and they will always be there. And like Daniel Osanto, who I think you said you
Yeah.
know, is my blood brother since the very beginning, probably one of the best knife fighters in the world. And I got some funny stories I should tell you about Danny if we have time, but.
But I mean, people have been talking a lot about Bruce Lee with Once Upon a Time in Hollywood coming out, and Dan is one of the people who came out speaking very, very specifically
We
about
can
Bruce.
certainly talk about that today if you want, because I was there,
Yeah.
But the long and the short is, Danny always used to say, people always chase the guy, on the football field, they chase the guy with the ball, meaning, he's the most important guy. So I guess some people say, hey, you should be honored that people are disparaging you and making fun of you and lying about you and making up bullshit rumors about you, but I don't have time for it. I find it revolting and just disgusting.
Well, because we brought it up, I'd love to follow up, if you're comfortable with talking about it. A lot has been said about this portrayal of Bruce Lee in this new Tarantino movie, which, to be fair, I've not seen the movie, but having trained with people who knew him very directly, what I've been told has not been very encouraging about the way that they have portrayed
Okay,
Bruce the
so
Man.
the real question is, where did Quentin Tarantino get this idea that, some stunt person beat up Bruce Lee? I personally think it was just some random, writing with people who wrote that, and that there was no rumor behind it, and that's why he wrote it. But I may be very, very wrong. Jean LaBelle, who wants to say that, he's the stunt guy who beat up Bruce Lee. Jean LaBelle is somebody who made his entire career lying about who he beat up. He beat up Jim Brown. I don't know if you guys know who Jim Brown is, but he was one of the greatest football players in the history of the world and a very, very, very tough, nasty guy if he had to get nasty. And I promise you, Jean LaBelle did not beat him up. But Jean LaBelle calls himself Judo Jean LaBelle. We had experts look in every Kodokan, Budokan, Judokai, everywhere to see if this guy had one black belt. We couldn't find one. And what everybody came back to me and said is, he's never even studied judo. So he walks around telling everybody he's Judo Jean LaBelle, tells everybody he beat me up, he choked me out, he beat up Bruce Lee, he choked out Bruce Lee, he went to some big, fight somewhere where there's some people fighting in the audience and they're endangering people, so he beat up one of them and killed him, and he had to go into hiding. I mean, the guy is a pathological liar. And I personally do not think that Jean LaBelle ever beat up anybody. And if he did, it's not,
It definitely wasn't Bruce Lee.
it wasn't Bruce Lee. And I was very, very close friends with James Coburn and saw Bruce over at James's house many, many times. And I can tell you for sure, Bruce is also the kind of guy that Jean LaBelle did not choke out or beat up. So it's for me, it's very disappointing that people in Hollywood can make their lives by making up bullshit, to try to make themselves something that they're not.